Hey guys, hope you're doing well. Have you ever thought about moving to Alberta instead of Ontario? Or have you ever wondered which province among the two would be good for you right now, given the huge competition and the effects of the pandemic? In today's video, I'm going to compare both the provinces using 9 important points which you should also consider when you're deciding which provinces to pick when you're moving to Canada. These 9 points would be helpful if you're already in Canada as well, and if you're looking for a change. The research for this video has been quite time consuming, and I've taken a lot of effort to bring these points for you guys, so do watch the video till the end as I'm going to be covering everything you might consider while moving, like the population, the weather, cost of living, salaries and taxes, the jobs and job sectors which are in demand in both provinces, along with the minimum wages offered, rent rates, transportation, and the really important question of which province among the two is better for long-term investments like buying your first home in Canada. Hey guys, this is Jason from Dream Canada. If you're new to the channel, I show people how to save their money and immigrate to new countries through my videos without the help of any immigration consultants or agents or lawyers. You can find all process instructions for you to apply on your own through this channel. Subscribe now because all the information provided here is completely free, and I answer all your queries in the comment section and on my social handles on Instagram and Twitter, so don't forget to follow us there as well. Let's start with the first point, which is population. Ontario is Canada's most populous province at around 14.5 million, which is around 38.3% of the country's total population. And it's also the second largest province by total area after Quebec. In comparison, the population of Alberta is just around 4.5 million, which is almost 4 times lesser than Ontario, despite being the 4th largest province in Canada after Quebec, Ontario, and British Columbia. Next, we come to a major point that will influence your decision, which is the weather. Ontario's climate varies by season and location. It's generally warm and dry in summer throughout May to September. Winters are typically cold and windy, with frequent snowfall throughout December to February. At an average temperature of 22 degrees Celsius, July is the hottest month of the year. February is the coldest month, with temperatures averaging minus 7 degrees Celsius. Alberta has a humid continental climate with warm summers and really cold winters with frequent heavy snowfall. The climate is typically mild and dry in the summer throughout May to August. However, Arctic air masses in the winter produce extreme minimum temperatures varying from minus 54 degrees Celsius in northern Alberta to minus 46 degrees Celsius in southern Alberta. At an average temperature of 17 degrees Celsius, July is the hottest month of the year. December is the coldest month, with temperatures averaging minus 8 degrees Celsius. So as you can see, someone who can't handle really cold weather would be better inclined towards Ontario. Next, we come to the average rent rates in these provinces. The rent that you'll be paying every month directly affects the amount of savings you'll be making in the long run, so this is something you'll need to be really careful of. The average rent for a decent family-sized apartment in Ontario is around $1,800 to $2,800, depending on the city, size, and amenities offered, whereas the rent for the same sized apartment would be around $1,000 to $1,500 in Alberta. So as you can see, Alberta is a much cheaper province to live in, and you'll also be able to find more options and listings when compared to Ontario. On a related note, we come to the cost of living. Jumping right to it, the cost of living in Ontario is higher than that in Alberta, and to break it up for you with a few examples, a mid-range restaurant meal for two would cost you around $100 in Ontario, whereas it would cost you around $75 in Alberta. Do remember to keep at least a 15% tip in mind as well, as the tipping culture is quite followed in Canada, and those in the service industry do deserve their tips, especially now. A monthly transit pass in Ontario for your transportation would cost you $156, whereas it would cost you just $109 in Alberta. Childcare, on the other hand, is more expensive in Alberta at around $1,200 for a single day, whereas it's around $900 in Ontario. Overall, as an example, at any given time, you would need around $6,700 in Ontario to maintain the same standard of living that you can have with just around $5,500 in Alberta. So that means you'll be able to save more money at the end of each month, which might be really handy to buy your first house or your first car in Canada. or even if you want to send some extra money each month to your families in your home country. Now we come to salaries and taxes. Since the average salary would differ based on different fields of work, I'll tell you about the minimum wage offered in both these provinces. The basic minimum wage in Ontario is around $14 per hour, whereas it's $15 per hour in Alberta. That extra dollar per hour coupled with a lower cost of living means you'll be saving more money in Alberta in the long run. Coming to the taxes, the provincial tax rates in Ontario start at 5.05% on the first 45,000 of your taxable income, whereas in Alberta, it starts at 10% on the first 131,000 of your taxable income. However, what you may not know is that Alberta only starts taxing residents once they are making over $19,000, which is the most generous personal exemption in the country. As a comparison, Ontario has a personal exemption amount of just $12,000. If you earn more than $19,369 to up to $131,000 in Alberta, you'll pay just 10% tax. And since the median Albertan income is just $36,000, almost everyone falls into the 0 to 10% category. Apart from these taxes, there are also other types of taxes like provincial sales tax or harmonized sales tax, which you don't have to pay in Alberta, whereas there's a 13% harmonized sales tax in Ontario. Federal taxes, as you may know, is the same for all provinces, which is 15% on the first 49,000 of your taxable income. So as a conclusion, Alberta is one of the best places to live from a tax perspective if you're a very low or a very high income earner. Next, we come to the jobs and job sectors in demand in both these provinces. In Ontario, the major jobs or job sectors in demand are from tech and IT, business and finance, life sciences, healthcare, marketing managers, translators, drivers, and physiotherapists. In Alberta, the major jobs or job sectors in demand are from the energy sector, as it's an oil and natural gas rich province. So occupations in demand are from the oil and gas, energy and renewable energy sectors, technology, manufacturing, transportation and logistics, real estate, agriculture, financial services, and creative industries as well, like design, music, publishing, architecture, and film and television. Now moving on to transportation. The modes of transport you can use in Ontario are subways, buses, streetcars, interregional commuter rail and bus lines by GO Transit, and you don't really need to buy a car as everything is so well connected, except for the harsh winter months when you might face a little trouble and discomfort while using public transportation in the cold winter months. A monthly transit pass in Ontario for your transportation would cost you $156 Canadian. If you do get a car, the price of gas per litre is around $1.25 in Ontario. Parking is really expensive in Ontario as well, so you'll have to take that into consideration if you decide to buy or rent a car. The Alberta Transit Systems operate a fleet of buses, trains and shuttle buses. They are well connected here as well, so you won't need a car, especially in popular cities like Calgary and Edmonton. A monthly transit pass in Alberta for your transportation would cost you just $109. The price of gas per litre is slightly cheaper in Alberta at around $1.23. Parking is slightly cheaper in Alberta as well when compared to Ontario. Now we come to the next point, which is what you can do on your weekends. Ontario is a more urban province and is home to the world-renowned Niagara Falls, along with Canada's top museums and galleries. You can spend family time at the amusement parks and relax at lakeside resorts as well, along with visiting some iconic landmarks like the CN Tower. In southern Ontario, just 2 hours from Toronto, Algonquin Provincial Park is one of the most popular parks and outdoor destinations, with an extensive network of hiking trails and beautiful lakefront campgrounds. Killarney Provincial Park is another great area for hiking, canoeing and camping. Alberta is an important skiing destination for tourists. It has several world-class ski resorts, Canada Olympic Park with its downhill ski and ski jumping facilities is one such example located in the city of Calgary. Alberta also contains significant natural scenery, including 6 of Canada's 20 UNESCO World Heritage Sites. The glaciers and turquoise lakes of Banff and Jasper National Parks are among them. Calgary is a modern city in Alberta, with a wealth of entertainment options. It's most famous for the annual Calgary Stampede. Farther north, the capital Edmonton is home to West Edmonton Mall, which is the largest shopping center in Canada, along with numerous other cultural attractions. Now we come to a very important point, which is buying a house. I've already told you that the minimum wage in Alberta is more than Ontario. Now this, coupled with the lower cost of living in general, will leave you more savings to buy your first big investment in Canada, which is a house. In Ontario, the average price for a detached house with at least 3 bedrooms and 3 bathrooms is around $750,000. Now keep in mind that these figures would differ from house to house depending on the total area, the location that you choose, and the social attractions around it. In Alberta, the same sized house with 3 bedrooms and 3 bathrooms would cost you just around $500,000 to $550,000, which is a huge difference. So as you can see, you can end up buying a home in Alberta much sooner than Ontario, as you'll be earning more, spending less, and you'll be getting much more value for the same amount of money in the long run. So as a conclusion, if you wish to live in a modern urban province where you have a lot of job opportunities, and if your work experience is inclined towards IT, tech, banking, marketing, finance, or the healthcare sector, then Ontario may be a good pick for you. But if you prefer to live in the foothills or near vast nature reserves or beautiful lakes and rivers, and your work is mostly inclined towards traveling, the oil and gas industry, or energy, then Alberta is the better pick for you. Alright guys, so that was a comparison between Ontario and Alberta. For more immigration and travel tips, subscribe to this channel now. Do like this video if you like the content, and comment which province you're more inclined towards. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe for regular updates on immigration, and don't forget to follow us on Instagram as well. I wish you the best of luck for your application, and hope you have a great day.